How you can animate a quit layout on page load. I'll show you this today with Vue.js transitions. Let's start right now. What's going on? My name is Mario. Welcome to another video. If this is your first time here and you wanna learn more about Vue.js or other related stuff, start now by subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. Okay, what we built today is this amazing staggered animation on page load. I wanna make this with these images here, it's a nice quit layout, but you can make this with any other elements like teaser or even complete website parts, there are no limits. Now I have already prepared a little bit, so let's take a look. So I have created a new project and here in the app.vue file I have defined an array with some test data, basically only with a picture, and I have here a quit attribute. The value is a CSS class, I wanna use it later for the quit. With this we can create the quit layout dynamically. A little bit, not completely, but with the functionality we only need in this specific case. And in the style section I have prepared some global CSS definitions. Okay, let's start with the title, and if you wanna animate this single element on page load, or basically if this component here rendered, then you can implement this with a Vue.js transition. And there is a provided tag, respectively a component you can use, transition. It's a forever component. This allows you to add an entering and a leaving transition for any single element in general between these tags here. And this can also be a component, of course. And if you want to apply a transition on the initial render, you can add the appear attribute. So with this, I gonna define a name for the CSS transition, slide in. This is for the prefix you need for the CSS classes later. Okay, that's it in the template. Straight to the style and here, you should use the name from the transition tag as prefix, and the first class is the enter class, and this class would be automatically added to the element before the element is inserted and removed one frame after the element is inserted. Basically it's the initial state from the element. And for this I gonna define the opacity property to 0 and transform to the half scaling. The next class is the enterActive class. So I gonna use my prefix, slide in and enterActive. And this class can be used to define the duration, delay and easing curve for the entering transition. So let's do this, and I gonna set here the transition, apply to all properties with the duration and a normal ease animation. And that's it. Time to save and take a look. Yes, looks pretty good for the first step. And now I wanna create the quit layout for the cards, respectively with the images. So let's create a new component, a card component. With the basic structure. Okay, stick to the template and create a new div with the class card. And this card element needs some style. I gonna set the width to 100%, the height to maybe 200 pixels, and I wanna set the image as background image, so I set the position to center and the size to cover, so that the image is adjusted and centered. Further, we need a class for the first version of our quit items, where I define the column width with span 1, and we need the second class, I copy this quickly, but with the horizontal span of 2, and change this one. By the way, before we can see here anything, we should import this component in the app component right here. And register them. And I'm gonna output this component here in the template with a v4 loop. I fetch the item as card and the index from the cards array. As a key, I write card and the index as the dynamic part. And here I provide the card as item and the current index. With this, I can fetch the provided data in the card component, item and index. Now I'm gonna bind the image from each card as a background image, so I use the style binding here on the card element. And here, I wanna use a computed property to keep this code here clean. Grid style. And define this property here in the computed attribute. The binding respects an object, so I return an object here and set background image as key and as a value the provided image. You need require here for the Webpack bundler, otherwise the image can't be found. I save now to see if it works. Okay, time to set up the grid layout. I'm gonna create here a new div with the class grid wrapper. And let's define this class with display grid. And I set a template for the columns. Dynamically with repeat. As the first argument, you can set the number of columns. I gonna use 2 in this case. And as the second argument, you can set the width from each column. And if you want it responsive, you can set here 1 fraction. This means that each column has the same width based on the absolute width. In this case, 50%. If you write here 4 elements, then 25% width, and so on. Last but not least, I wanna have a little space between the grid elements, so I define here a grid gap with 10 pixels. Back to the card component, I gonna set the different card class as bindings, also with a computed property. I name it grid class. And create it right here. And I return here an object with the first class as key and a condition as value. If the value item grid equal to the class, then bind this class to the element. And the same for the second class. So I copy this quickly and change the difference. Quick save and let's take a look. Okay, that fits. Now, how can you animate this grid? For more elements, there are a second provided wrapper component named transition group. And that works just like the other one. I change my div to this component. And you can also use the appear attribute, the same name for the sliding animation. Slide in this case. You can also specify which element this component should be with the tag attribute, and I want a div. The default behavior is a span tag. I save quickly, and yes, the animation works great. But we want a staggered animation, where each element appears step by step, respectively with a little delay, right? There is a really cool little CSS trick you can use. I used it in previous projects. You can add her a CSS variable to each element, and as a value, you can use the current index. And now you can use in the transition class interactive a transition delay. I wanna use a calculation 100 milliseconds, and here you can use this CSS variable by using var and the variable. And with this, each element has a different starting time. The first 100 milliseconds, the second 2, the third 300, and so on. Let's save this, and you see a great page load animation. Awesome! Your support pushes me and gives me the ambition to keep going and keep bringing you the best content possible and making you a better web developer. And if you like my tutorials and you wanna support me, then you have the opportunity to become a patron. And as a patron, you have some benefits. You get the source code from my tutorials, you get a special rank on my Discord server, you can vote for new tutorial topics, and much more. Apart from that, you can always come to my Discord, where we can discuss and help each other. You find the links below in the video description. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.